cowboy, bitch, you what? Oh my God, what's that? I'm an alien. Oh no, oh no, don't worry, I come in peace. Really? That's good. Well, I don't. Pew, 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 pew. I lie, neither do I. Pew, 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 pew.
Hi, I'm Jeff Becker, creator of Alterkind. Here to talk to you about my new book, Planetary Survey. Inside Planetary Survey, you'll find all sorts of... Dude. Blank pages. That sucks. I guess that's why I need your help. So, I'm here to talk to you about it. If you scroll down a little bit, you'll see a little flip book there. A little bit further. Yeah. No. Over... Yeah, right there. So, inside that is what I kind of hope it looks like when it's all done. To help me out, I'm here to beg for your money. Got all sorts of great pledge levels, starting with this cool little sticker here for just a couple bucks. Further levels include these sweet little pins with all sorts of the new races. Got the Paracor, the Oldham, and the Etikin. Different levels include some of the books in different formats, including, of course, Planetary Survey, because that's what this is for. Other ones include the Player's Handbook, which inside you'll find all sorts of stuff like prestige classes, mutations, cybernetics. Further, you can go ahead and pledge and get Dossier. It's my second book. It's in beautiful color. Check that out. It's full of more class options. You can customize everything, all that. And then you can also go ahead and get The Ones We Were. It's a module for it. Got all sorts of cool little mutants in there. Aliens crash. There's a crazy cult leader. Also, if you go ahead, you can get this awesome GM screen designed by Stephen McAndrews. He's a pretty sweet dude. On the back is all the helpful information so you don't get lost. Yeah, so that's my stuff. I hope you check it out. Share with your friends, anyone that might be interested in, you know, role-playing. Use a D20 Pathfinder kind of system. Yeah, great. And thank you for checking me out. I look forward and I'm hopeful that you help me out. Later. Oh, hey, I forgot to tell you about some of the reviews that I've got. Denver Comic Con calls me a favorite. There was a guy there that said, hey, this looks pretty cool. I think I'll tell my friend about it. My mom, she says, that's nice, dear. And she also thinks I'm very handsome. So, thanks for checking me out. I really appreciate it. Go ahead and tell your friends about it. And thanks again.
Oh.
Hi, I'm Scott Gable here at Zombie Sky Press. You ever wish you had more Pathfinder role-playing game options for the Fae? More delightfully weird options? As a longtime lover of the Fae, I've been hunting far and wide for more ways to incorporate them into my gaming life. And the answer, my friends, is the Fairy Ring. This is the book that gets into the nitty-gritty, into the down and dirty of all things Fae. It spills all their darkest secrets and pulls out your inner trickster. This is the book the Fae do not want you to read. But we've got you back, friends. We think you need to know, and soon. We're so close to finishing this first step, and the design and the illustrations are blowing us away. The book has 10 chapters focused on powerful Fae lords. Maybe they're the bad guys in a campaign, maybe they're the patrons of the party, maybe they're both. Each chapter provides extensive details on a specific Fae lord and their servitors. Each chapter has a new Fae player race, new Fae monsters, cities, planes, and more. I can't wait for you to see what we have planned, and I hope you'll support Zombie Sky Press in bringing you more Fae.
If it does, by then my wife will come.
Alright, so these dice are also your action dice.
Okay.
So on the dice, there's run, okay, where you could do your double movement. Alright, so what you do is you grab your dice, you pull your dice out of the bag, it's yours, and you go, okay, this guy's going to run, so he's going to do his double movement, would be 10.
Okay.
Okay. Then there's Taking off my glasses to see. There is advance. Advance is you move and you could shoot.
Okay.
Okay. A little bit less. There's a one ball penalty for moving or
so whatever. The number comes down by one.
Yeah. And then there's advance, and then there's fire, and then fire is basically you're staying where you're at, and you're just shooting, but you get a minus or plus for the shoot, whatever the better one is.
Got it.
Okay.
Is it minus,
be a
one,
minus one?
Minus yeah. one to the roll or plus one to the range?
Minus one for the roll.
Okay.
Then there is down, which basically. You're getting down.
Taking cover.
It's hard. You're taking cover. A little harder for you to be hit and stuff like that. You're also trying to work off one of your pins. Okay?
Oh, okay.
Which is also rally.
Okay.
Rally is working off your pins. You're just there. You're not moving. You're not shooting. You're not doing anything. You're just going to try to roll off one of your pins.
Okay.
Because you want to be able to restore yourself.
What's the difference between down and rally? Down is
down
I take
is you just down.
Rally?
Yeah, down is you can't rally. You're just down. You're hiding. You're on
we're
down,
just hiding. Okay.
And you're a little harder to hit. Okay. And then
and rally is I'm still just standing there, same as always, but I'm trying to work off the pin.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
By the way, should I take this pin off from over here?
Yeah. Okay. And then so what you do is this works as also who went. Who moved, so these guys just fired you. And if you go, I don't know what they did, well, they advanced.
Okay.
So it's actually kind of smart. Because like I used to play War Machine and I'd be like, I'd have to put little markers by because I couldn't remember who went last and everything else. So this is kind of cool. So it's random and this is a good way to keep track of your guys.
Gray is gonna be my guys.
Gray's got your guys, green is my guys.
Okay, now what? So I actually know. What are my actual forces called?
Okay, they're the Gar.
They're the Gar, okay.
Yeah.
Was it the Gar?
Yeah, they're the Gar. I'll show you.
Gar!
Yeah.
They sound like space pirates. Gar!
They're actually space trolls.
Oh, okay. I'm cool with that too.
Yeah, they're actually space trolls.
Giant space trolls.
And I'll show you. This way, you get to see their stats.
Do you want me to give you a bookmark or something?
Yeah, I have a piece of paper or something. Okay. We'll use the chart cheat sheet. I have a receiver here. Okay, that's the Gar. And you can take a look at him real quick.
Okay. I got it. Don't worry, not gonna drop it.
No, I'm sorry.
Figured out my dilemma.
And that's how I broke all his stuff. G H A R Gar. Okay.
Sorry, I meant
Gelfads
and...
Oh wow, they wrote the point value right up front.
Yeah, that's one of those.
Arrow Squad. AG is what?
I think that's the advanced move. Hold on, let me see, I got it right here.
Okay. Because AG, ACC I'm guessing is accuracy. SCR is probably is strength, so I'm guessing weapon strength. Resistance. I'm guessing initiative, N-I-N-I-T, I'm guessing is initiative.
Yeah.
So is that
that's for,
close combat?
Yeah, close combat.
Who gets to attack first in a close combat situation? Okay. And then and CO is?
That's their command stat.
Okay. Oh, that's the thing for rallying and all that kind of stuff, okay.
It doesn't have it on here. Wow, okay.
Okay. AG aggro. No, just kidding.
Yeah, in the front of the book it tells you.
Oh, okay.
What all that is, I forget. I should know.
Oh, I see what they look like when they're not wearing their
yeah, they're naked.
They are really wormy little dudes.
Yeah, that's why they're hiding in the suits.
No kidding, I would too.
And they feel like nobody matters. They're just here to kill things.
Nobody understands us.
Yeah.
it looks like an army full of golems.
Yeah.
Especially considering how pale they are when they're painted.
Yeah. And they just like to kill and enslave people.
Okay. Fail pass from his test. Oh, I'm sure it's right up front.
Yeah.
AG, let's see. Pins. Turn order. It's probably even before that. I'm willing to bet that they talk about how to read the stat part like right up front. Size of the game. No. Wow, I overshot it. Because I went right to the table of contents. I gotta admit, though, the photography and the artwork in here is very nice.
Yeah, I have a friend that's a printer. He liked the book. He said it was really nice.
It's very clean. Agility.
Yeah, agility.
When a unit makes a sprint, it makes a test against its agility.
Okay.
Okay. And my guys have AG3, which means they are not that agile. I got three legs, man. I'm only working with what I got.
Exactly.
All right. So, okay. I guess I'll let you.
Okay. So what we do is go ahead. You grab yourself a dice.
And it's yours.
All right. So then, what I'm going to do is I'm gonna
be a jerk right out of the gate.
I'm gonna try this. I'm going to advance.
I kind of saw that coming, and I actually did not. I really thought you were gonna actually activate them first.
I don't know how well these guys shoot, but I think you guys can really knock me in the ass. So I'm not gonna go too crazy. The one I did play a demo of this. That's as far as I went. I played a demo, and
well, see, this is a demo as well. So.
Yeah, so we're both.
You've come so far. You've come so far all this time.
And the other force, I played the Freeborn, and I was a little bit more crazier. I moved, I ran into him and stuff like that, and it was pretty good. Okay, so I just moved. I'm going to try to shoot. And let me see what I have.
For distance?
Yeah. They're very long distance guns. And you have long, you have short, you have insane range.
Wait, there's actually a range band called Insane?
Well, I think Extreme. I'm saying Insane.
I like the idea of Insane. They should have that. It should be like short, medium, long, extreme, insane.
Yeah.
Or, you know, Insane, in parentheses, plaid.
He went plaid!
You never go full plaid.
Alright, let's see here.
No, I'm just thinking right now.
See, this is what I hate, because they don't have...
They don't have the ranges easily listed.
Minus it to
right.
Minus it to 3. Destroy that.
Strike squad.
Yep.
Okay, they all have plasma carbines. So now... Squish my guys. That's the only thing about
it. You're more folding the book back.
Yeah. That's the bad thing about having this huge book.
Yeah, but the hard cover is kind of nice. I mean, it does make the game, the book more durable.
Yeah.
No, I'd just rather doing a lot of misplays right now.
This sucks.
Worst comes to worst, we just fudge it.
Yeah, right?
You're like, yeah, everybody shoots 12 inches.
No, because I thought I was going to... It's creatures. I had this all down, too, and it's like... Oh,
I'm sure you will.
Concord. Vehicle. Weapons.
There you go.
I kind of ripped my mind.
All right, we got the plasma. Plasma carbine.
My friend's gonna see if she can get. Oh yeah, she'll let me know.
Single shot. Effective range is 20. Long range is 30, and extreme range is 50.
I think I'm
strike value is 2. Alright, but and then it should say how many shots. It doesn't say.
But didn't it say single shot right off the bat?
No.
Strike value. Oh, I see. Okay, I see.
Hey, Grace.
Two shots.
Okay. So 2 shots per guy.
Yeah, 2 shots per guy.
So you got 5 guys, that's 10 shots.
Alright. So we're gonna see if we're gonna try to shoot him.
All right. Now, these guys get it for being with some cover? Or do they not have
Yeah, it's going to minus for cover.
Okay.
Your turn.
You gotta have 20 inches. At least with the lead guy, right?
That's 23.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
So,
I mean, it did give me a shiny mountain.
So definitely we have one, two, three. These guys can't see him.
Okay.
I always wanted to use this.
Play a war game. See. That's how you find out if you get your chance to use the laser pointer.
Yeah, we'll say the three guys. So we'll do,
Okay, so you're gonna get six
first
shots.
Guy here, two guys. All right, and we needed,
What did you do? we forgot to figure out what the target number was. We're so bad at this.
Oh my god.
Well, we definitely have one shot that missed because it's a 10.
That's a miss. That's a definite miss.
Hey, see, we're already halfway there. Yeah, we're already resolved this one combat thing.
I'm thinking five.
What is it, like five base and then it works from there?
Yeah.
So five and then it would be down to like a four and then...
All right, so his accuracy is 5. All right, so to be able to hit you, I have to go 5 and under. All right.
And then, what, 1 for cover?
1 for cover.
So you'd be down to a 4, so it's still a hit.
So it still hits. You got 1 hit there. All right.
My guy's resistance, I think, was 10.
Right.
I think it was 10 to start, so I need an 8 or less.
Yeah.
Because it's a 2 strength.
So leave that there for now, and then let me roll my... I'll roll my other two dice for this guy.
Is it going to like mount up? Oh, so yeah. Double miss.
Double miss. There you go. I pretty much suck. And then there we go. Third guy right here. Let's see. Okay, so
and
we got
one hit.
We got one hit out of that. So now you roll those two hits.
Okay. So give me two dice.
Two dice.
And I need 8 or less to resist.
Right.
Okay. No, so I'm good on both. Because I'm 1, which is an auto success, right. And then 7, which is
so under. Now you got 1 pin because you were hit.
Oh, okay, so he still takes a pin for being hit.
Yeah.
Wait,
whether it be shot at.
Just for being shot at, okay.
Yeah.
It's not 1 pin per guy, it's just 1 or 1 pin per shot.
Well, being that he's a unit, it'd be 1 pin for him.
No, I meant like, I thought it would be like 1 pin for
each. Oh, no, it's 1 pin per unit.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so then what we do is, I can't do anything else. Now we dice in the bag, we see who goes next. So the only other thing, ambush, I'm sorry, with the control dice here, mm-hmm. Ambush is, if you want to do an ambush, say you're off to the side, mm-hmm. kind of sneaking out a little bit, you could go to ambush. At the end of the turn, you don't put that dice back, you leave it. And the next turn, if I'm walking by or something in your line of sight, you go stop right there, and then you could react and do a reaction.
Oh, okay.
Also,
I don't really have that set up well right
also
now.
Also, you could, I forgot to say about that, but when you do close combat, you can shoot in close combat.
Okay.
It's kind of silly if you're running to somebody and you can still pop off a few shots.
Okay.
Or if this thing has you in its claw, you're going to try to shoot at it.
Right.
I'm
going to punch this giant metal suit with my little meaty hand. Yeah. Okay, so I picked last time, so why don't you pick this time?
I'll pick. Yours.
I get to go.
Okay, so you get to go.
All right. So, what's the range on their? What do they have? Plasma cannons or something? I think it said.
Yeah, let's see.
Because I got one of two options. I'm gonna do. And I
yeah. They have the scour cannon. Yeah, it seems like they all have scour cannons.
Okay.
All right. And let's see here, what a scour can do.
So I figure I'm either going to advance or I'm going to fire. It depends on what ranges are and how many shots I get for a cannon.
I think you get 3 shots.
Oh man, that can be pretty brutal.
Yeah. 3 shots. These guys really, I don't know why they gave everybody, let's see here, Scour cannon, all right, 20, 30, and no extreme range.
Okay.
All right, and, Strike value is 2.
Yeah, I remember what I was going to tell you. There's this website that I just heard about.
So I have to roll a 2 in order to hit?
No.
No, that's the accuracy. Accuracy is what I've rolled it. Oh, it's a case of it's going to give you a negative 2.
Right.
Okay.
Where you can, right. You know how it's, like, it's so expensive.
So what you're going to do is, like, say, if my, it has a 2 on it,
what they do
and I just want to see how many shots.
So, like, usually in your American money, they show you how much costs.
I heard 3. I'm going to, I like the idea of 3.
So I am going to discard Wild Control for something. I really should use this for all of this, but I don't have mana. I'll pay 1 black.
Just have to strike that anyways. I'm sorry.
No, dude, you haven't played this in since your last demo,
right?
And I haven't played this ever, so you're fine. Don't even have to apologize for things that aren't your fault.
Roll a d10, shot, strike, hit.
What's your next card with that? Frog.
Well, if I did it, I mean red, so you could actually use that card. But then I'm thinking red's going to actually burn me out because I was at 6 life. Oh, it's good. It sucks because I'm going to die.
Do you like what I said?
Yeah.
They also have a lot of rerolls in this game, too. Roll resist.
Oh, Kalios is at the bottom.
Maybe you might be able to read this a little quicker than me.
Don't bet on it. My brother, we've seen the book before.
Yeah. Well, I got it in a section.
Okay. So let's see, intervening terrain, roll the hit modifier, duds, overthrow, aim shots, put on his rapid fire, focus on rapid fire, we'll get 2, 3 or more shots of rapid fire, on their RF value. Effective range is not, at effective range there is no penalty, but longer ranges shots suffer a -1 accuracy, for example, a rapid fire weapon. Okay, well, I don't know if my weapon can do rapid fire. Let me check your bookmark. Okay, so it's the scour cannon, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's see here.
I would love to get a jet.
Scour cannon! Alright, rapid fire of 3.
Right.
So I can rapid I guess it's a case of I normally get 1 shot.
I'll be right back.
Okay, I think I see what this is doing. It allows me to do several different things. So it's a case of, the scour cannon allows me to dispersed, concentrated, or disruptor. So apparently I have options on how I want to do this.
Right.
So I could do is I could either do dispersed, which is that 20-30, and then no extreme range, strike value of 2, rapid fire of 3. I could also do concentrated, 20-30-40, strike value of 4, but it doesn't do anything else.
Right.
So I guess it's one, and that's 1 shot. Or I could do disruptor, 20-30, no extreme range, strike value of 1, but it blasts.
Oh, okay.
So it does a blast of D4, no cover, and has disruptor effect, which I don't know what that means. So how about this? I'm not going to bother with that one. However, the rapid fire of 3 sounds kind of fun.
Okay.
So why don't I do... Now, if I do the fire option,
I'm gonna go get
there's no penalty for the movement. It's just a case I'm just staying where I am and they shoot.
Right.
But the thing is, I have to be at range. So I'm going to, in order to make that rapid fire work and not take the penalty, I do have to advance. Which is going to, I still need a -1. Actually, I'm going to take -1 either way. I'm going to take a -1 either because I move or I'm going to take a -1 because of range. I might as well just stay where I am and keep my cover. And then take my shot. So I'm gonna put fire order on him.
Okay.
and I will take the, I'm going to do Scour Cannon with Dispersed. I would take a negative one for range. Oh, actually, I'd be taking a negative two for that, because I take one negative one for range, and then negative one because I'm rapid firing. So I'm actually better off actually taking the advanced option, so I can move up, and I'm only at negative one at that point, rather than negative two. So we'll take advance. I'm sorry about that.
No problem.
I'm just going to move him. I'll just move him up here, and I should give him enough distance. We'll double check it.
Mm-hmm.
Can I have the tape mirror?
Thank you.
And show me 20 inches. 20 inches is there. Sorry, I really ought to do it this way. Shouldn't I? I've got 20. Oh, I could have actually stayed where I was. 20 inches is actually good for where I was. Oh, well. Tough cookies. Should have measured it first. All right, so we'll shoot. And I get three shots. And my accuracy is... I have to look up the guy from the sheet. That actually was on that. Let's see here. It's a bunch of dudes, not my guys. Nope. I think I overshot. Go a little slower this time. Not my guys, no. Warring ages. Show me armor lists. Boromites.
Yeah, this will be the thing from Fantastic Four.
Yeah, I was going to say, yeah. They kind of look like that. Accuracy, 5. So it's going to be 5, 4, and that's it. So I need 4s and under, but it's strength 10. Okay, I think that makes sense. All right, so I get 3 shots. Move this die out of the way. I need 4s and under. I got 1 hit.
Okay.
The Scour Cannon has a strike value of...
I think it was 2.
2. So, your guys, I don't know what your resistances are. You're all handy the book. Have a book.
So. Read a book.
Thank God that they're pretty much close to each other. Okay, so my resistance, so I don't understand that either. That's like 5/7. Why do they do that? Why do they do the slash bullshit?
I have no idea.
Alright, well, the last time I played, I kept it at 5, so...
So it would be 5, you're down to 3s?
Yeah.
So you have to make 1 die roll against a 3. Which you fail.
Which I fail. God, I have the worst luck ever. He's dead. They're in.
Take that, you humans. With your...
Oh my God.
With your right. Squishy flesh bodies.
Yeah. I told you. I went from 1s to 10s. It's crazy. That's just like playing Warhammer. I had five Terminators. They save on 2s.
I now have to put down multiple tokens. You just rotate the token.
Yeah.
I didn't realize that until just now. Like, there's a bunch of numbers.
Yeah, I had to paint that white, yeah. Because a lot of people couldn't see.
I'm guessing it's all red originally?
Huh?
It's all red originally?
It's all red.
That's why you're not going to see it. Yeah.
Yeah. So the thing of it is I rolled 5 1s. Lost the whole Terminator squad. It was funny as hell.
Yeah, some games it's a case of no matter what you do, it does come down to the dice, but the problem is the numbers are so insane that you're never going to make them. Okay, so I guess you're pulling out a die. Oh, no, I'm pulling out a die because you pulled out one last time. It just happened to be mine. And it's one of yours.
Wow, okay.
Oh, look, we're being nice to each other. And then shooting at each other.
And,
it's so passive aggressive, it's great.
Again, like I've seen games online and stuff where this one guy continuously went. He's like, oh my God! So he finally started ambushing.
Yeah.
Because he's like, there's the only way I'm gonna get a chance to play this damn game.
Yeah.
All right. So this group here is gonna run. Because they're suicidal.
As long as they're not sprinting, because then you gotta make that agility test, apparently.
Yeah, no, they're just a regular run move.
Okay.
Alright, so they're doing a 10. They're gonna come up to this building here.
Yes! Closer.
Yeah.
Move further towards the kill zone, please.
Because the thing that is we would never have a game if I just cowered, so we're gonna just...
Well, also, you don't have a lot of cover where you put some of these guys. I mean, you know, they're easily
right,
found.
Right, right, right. Yeah, I think we probably would need a lot of cover, but that's all right.
Oh, you get to go again.
Oh.
Because you're right. Well, there's nothing else going on.
Well, I gotta wake up. All right, so yeah, we're gonna do this. We're gonna...
Come on, just keep moving on, advancing. I like you advancing like that.
There's no, there's no, like some games that give you, like a little off for like flanking somebody or something like that.
Well, you have actually a nice flank ability here because this is going to offer some terrain.
Yeah.
This will offer you some cover. So, I mean, that's actually not a bad way to go. And I don't have a lot of presence over here. I've got like two guys, you know.
So we're going to do, we'll run.
To be honest, that's what I would do. I'd probably run them or even sprint them. I'd probably even go for the agility test, make the sprint, and try and get it into this. So well, that would give you only 15 inches, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
You still wouldn't make it. Well, no, you'd be in it, just not by much.
Well, it'll make the game a little bit more.
Yeah. Well, here's the other thing. Actually, you have the embankment here, which actually cuts off your legs by eyeball.
All right. So they ran.
They've got cover.
Okay.
All right. Pick one. Pick one of mine. Well, you only have one spot left.
Yeah, there was one where the guy didn't want to get picked yet.
Yeah.
There you go. All
right. I'm going to put the ambush on him.
Okay.
So that's his turn.
All right.
There you go. Let's see here. And it's one of yours.
Yay.
See, we're so nice to each other. It's delightful.
Okay. yeah, they're going to run. They're crazy. Bonsai.
Now, here's my question. If you're going to have them run through all that terrain, what's the inch loss for going through the terrain?
You would have to do your, I think it's your agility or something like that, where you're going to take a test.
Right.
To see if you could go over it.
Okay.
And then I think it's just halfway or something.
Oh, okay.
Because it's hard, depending on the terrain, if it's easy. This is definitely very difficult terrain.
Yeah, it's all...
So we're going to go around.
Oh.
So we're going to go like...
weak.
Five.
I get to take a shot. Wait, are you advancing or are you running?
I'm running.
Oh, okay.
And
I was going to say, drawing you go five. Oh, you're going five that way and then you go five. Oh, I can get the die.
I'm doing a lateral.
Okay, I see what you're saying. Sounds like... Alright, if you're just gonna move five, I would have advanced and then taken a long shot.
Alright.
Here you go.
Cool. See, I thought when I saw these, I thought you had to roll them
and then
told you what. Yeah.
That would make the game
really crazy.
That would make the game so random it would be virtually unplayable.
Yeah.
Hey, look, you apparently have another action.
Wow. Is that you know what? They're counting a drone squad. That's one squad. Yeah, they're counting a drone squad.
So I just remove that one?
Yeah.
Okay. That's what I was like, at this point there should be nothing left with my own. Okay, well, I pulled the black die.
That is a dispersed die. I think basically, I don't know how exactly that runs. Basically, I think it freezes up one of my units or keeps them down or something.
Oh, okay.
So, like,
what?
You can choose one of mine, and I guess if they're, as long as they're in range or something like that, you could make me go down and stay one turn.
But your guys already went, so I can't do anything.
Yeah, with
it. So I guess this gets put to the side.
So we pick another one.
Oh yay, it's one of mine. all right. So, wait, how many dice are left in there?
Maybe
one, two, three. I got three. So not everybody on my side goes every round.
Okay. No. It might be squads of three.
Do we want to check that real quick? Yes. So, and if that's going to be the case, I can move some things around and
I'll
move one of my guys over to make an actual squad and whatnot.
Let's see. Intermission. Yeah, outcast command squad. No. Gar assault squad. One set is assault, one set is the shooting. So you have one Gar leader with a gouger and plasma claws. So the guys with the claws
are supposed to be
the assault. And then you have the other guys, so it's three. So you have three guys as one squad, three guys as another. And they do have to
do it. Okay, so let's transform this. Okay, so this guy's here. This guy would have been over here. Because he would have been, that being cohesion.
This is a learning moment. Learning moment.
And we'll move him over here?
Yeah.
Call that okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So, can I take the ambush from here and redo this guy?
Yes.
And move it for these guys?
Move it the way you want.
Okay.
Learners here. We're just learners. We got to learn. Learners permit.
I used to teach driving. Fun stories I'll tell off camera. Here, can I have the measure? Okay. We're gonna do 5 inches, and then I can make an attack.
Okay.
So he moves to here. He moves to here. I feel like I'm moving tripods here, like from War of the Worlds.
Mm-hmm.
All Quiet on the Martian Front style. Okay. You don't have to bring him over just a little bit. All right. So we'll bring him in. Everybody's definitely cohesion at that point. This die will go for this guy in the back once I get to him, but let me take care of these guys first in that order. Actually, I can shoot to here. That is definitely within some range there. So it's out. It's 23, 24 inches. So this is the shooty squad.
Right.
There you go. They also have the gougers, or they have gougers and something else?
They have the, yeah. I think they have the...
We need all the immortal bear.
These guys are scour cannons. These guys are scour cannons. Scour, plasma claw, disruptor, destructor. Okay. So yeah, these guys have much better armed than these dudes. And all their stats are pretty much the same. Alright. Okay, so I'm gonna take a shot. It'd be -1. Actually -1 for range and -1 for movement. And we'll do concentrated for them. So I'm gonna get 3 shots total. I'm shooting the blue squad that you have in. And so -1 for range, -1 for movement. And they have an accuracy of 5, so I need 3s. And why did I close the entire book like a jerk?
That's all right.
Here, have your book back. Take your damn book and your learning. Alright, so, but here's the thing, it's a case of if I hit, it's strength 4. So just keep that in mind. So it's basically going to be an instant kill if I can hit with these. So I need 3s. Looking for 3s. This one's cocked. 2 hits.
Okay.
The 8 will not work. So if they're strength 4 and your guys have resistances of 3. Oh no, wait, they have resistance of 5.
Right.
So they need 1s. Roll those 10s!
It was so cool that he went home.
Oh, you got 1! One guy left.
Yeah.
So you lose 1 guy.
So I get 1 left.
Yeah. So 1 guy's out.
And you get a pin.
Yep.
Alrighty.
And I get to move my last guy.
Move your last guy?
He's
Fartok. He's your...
He's Fartok?
Fartok.
Fartok! Okay. Do I have a sprint on here? Run. Rally. Can he rally for somebody else? Because I guess he's like the commander anyway.
Yeah, he's the commander.
So can I use like my rally order to try and remove this pen?
I don't know.
Sounds like something I'd be allowed to do.
I don't know. I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
I don't know.
Okay. Can I put down a run and then make it a sprint instead?
I guess you could do that, yeah.
Okay, what's my agility for this guy?
You gotta watch him when it's it's called up. This is where I leave him. He's very good in that one.
He's a specialized character. I am so gonna make up an army list. I'm gonna print all this out. Yeah. This is just crazy.
Oh, you know what? I was also thinking about it. I just realized, considering we never did these guys because we had that whole Outer Wonder thing, I'm going to take, after I move this guy, because he's just sprinting anyway, I'm just going to make these guys take the, they'll combine their shots.
All right, they have a command, command of 9, and special rules here. It says,
What's his agility? Because that's all I'm worried about right now.
Agility is 3.
Okay, so I have to make a test of 3, or it fails. And I rolled a 7, which means I failed. So what happens if I fail my sprint?
You're what's wrong with this country.
Derek, you think if I show Casey danger 5, you think Casey would lose his mind?
Obviously my guy is the clumsiest jerk ever. If the result for a failed sprint is that he trips over and hurts himself and kills himself, I'm gonna laugh. I'm putting that out there. Your guy tried to run, but he's so clumsy and so bad at it, he killed himself.
He just killed himself.
Table flip.
And what else we needed? We need his command value, or?
No, it's a case of, oh, I was gonna have him do a sprint, so I just need to find out what happens when you fail a sprint at this point. That's why I was asking what his agility score was.
Oh, yeah, from.
No, it's going to be under whatever the basic. It's going to be under the movement rules, I would assume.
All right.
For sprinting.
Mm-hmm. Sprint. Sprint. Okay. So it looks like summary on sprint tests. You pass on a 1 automatically. Pass, no penalty. Fail, exhausted 1 pin. Fail on a 10, exhausted 2 pins.
My guy, okay, so he's got 1 pin on him. And I guess he doesn't do anything, he just stays there. Wow. He's really bad at what he does.
Yeah, a sprint, a run action is normally a 2 move up to 10 inches. Units that move standard.
Okay. Yeah. Alright, so you know what, let's take care of the other two guys because they never got to do their thing and they would have been part of this, they would have been on the same setting. It was rapid fire. So they get 3 shots apiece.
Okay.
So I'm gonna be rolling 6 dice. For those two guys who just never got their shots. Because that whole confusion about what makes a squad.
Right.
And let's see, accuracy was 5. Oh, so it's actually 5. It's gonna be 5 for them. So. Let's see here. I have, out of all this, 2 hits.
Okay.
Because I rolled a 4 and a 2. Oh no, I'm sorry, I think the back there's 1 more corner. So I hit with half. Actually, that's not bad.
Yeah.
But I have a couple 10s in there. Sort of sucks. Alright, so you gotta guard against that.
How many? 3?
Yeah, you gotta roll against 3. Strike value of 2, so you're making 3s or less on 3 dice. You got a 30% chance, 11.
Yeah. These 3 guys here.
Yeah. Oh, one of them is just your commander.
Because you're supposed to allocate like that.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay. So
I'm going to allocate this guy, not the commander.
So the one guy behind cover. Got it. Who I can't.
I can't even see.
No, actually, he can do it.
We'll make the commander. Here we go. We're going to lose 10.
We're losing all of them.
Yeah, I suck.
Oh, lordy. Oh, you're.
And plus, I had a pin, so that would have made it, yeah.
The pin would have been what happened then, because remember, it was a case of these two are rolling now because they were part of the squad that went, but we didn't know they were a squad.
Right.
So it was a case of they're just getting the shots that they didn't get before because we were confused.
Oh, they're dead. Silly. He's gonna run away.
Run away! Oh, because he's gonna. He fails.
Over, yeah. He's over his.
Oh, okay.
This thing.
Come
on. Then.
All right. So I guess we pull all the dice except for the. Oh, right. Because
except for the ambush. Squad.
Well, the ambush actually doesn't happen because
right.
That would have been for another squad that doesn't exist.
Okay. Get the pin out of here. All right.
And my one guy in the back is exhausted because he's dumb.
I'm sure.
How did he make commander? Nepotism.
I'm sure if we read the rules really good and all this stuff, he probably kicks major ass, but.
Yeah, but for a quick demo game, it's fine.
Yeah. But I'm liking the game. I really do. And
I just feel a little bit bad because I'm like, oh yeah. And by the way, these guys got their shots. And oh, by the way, your whole squad's gone.
Okay, you go first.
Oh, apparently I do. You know, I'm going to start with these guys. They're going to advance.
All right.
And they get 5 inches.
We lose or draw, we're definitely doing this again. We're going to get together again.
Oh, yeah, no. This is great. This is great. As long as you don't mind driving them.
I love coming out here. You can.
And
it's not a problem. I hop on 195 and I just drive the whole way up. Okay.
What's your deal like now? What's your deal like with Sundays? Is Sundays the only days you can get
no,
out?
No, it fluctuates just because of the fact that you know, baby.
Oh, okay.
Everything's baby driven. Like after we're done here, I actually have to check in to find out if my wife wants me to come home.
Oh, okay. No problem.
She's like, well, maybe. It depends on how long it takes. Da 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 da. How much did the squad go back? 20, well, you're pulling off. Yeah, I was going to say, you're pulling off here.
23. That's the top guy's at 21.
Okay. So it's going to be 21 to 23 because of these guys. So there's going to be negative one for each.
Okay.
So is he negative one?
You know what? Let's try out that blast setting.
All right, here.
All right, so.
Take a look at that.
Blast is. Well, I don't know. It sounds pretty wicked.
We got that circle is your blast template.
Oh, that's gonna be sort of bad for you.
yeah. Well, the next time, what we're gonna do is we'll play with the drones. We'll play with so I get a little bit more protection. Right now, we're just.
Oh yeah, sure. I'll blame it on the fact you don't have your drones.
Yeah.
You know, it's a bad carpenter that blames his tools.
Right. I was like, well, I'll just show him how to play the game. But I'm not like. I did a demo for X-Wing one time. And the guy's like, I'm just showing him how the game goes and everything else. And he's like, but how do I win? How do I win? How do I win? And I'm like, don't worry about winning right now. Just worry about learning how to play the game. But no, you're not going to show me how to win.
Well, if you want to know what the scenario's win condition is, that's one thing.
Right. No, yeah. This was like, just let me show you how to shoot. Yeah. Let me show the ranges. What the range rule is.
I got to figure out what this blast. The blast thing is what I'm looking for, is just what the rule for that is. My guess is the D4 is it's a case of, like, that's the added strength to
right.
The blast.
I know we could drift along.
Right. Heavy weapons, I don't know why it's... Gouger cannon. Oh! Did you know that apparently after I shoot you with a gouger cannon, your guys automatically go to down?
Really?
Yes.
Holy crap.
So, okay, just so you know what this means. Okay. Apparently it has a minimum range. The gouger cannon has a minimum range of 10 inches. So anything less than 10 inches cannot engage targets that are closer than the measured in the standard way. Down. A unit hit by a gouger cannon automatically goes down after shooting has been worked out. It does not matter whether casualties are caused or not. The target takes a down, goes down if one or more hits are scored. If the target has an order die left in the die bag, from the die back and place it in the unit to show that it has gone down. If the target has already used its order die, then change its current order to down. Inaccurate. The missile is inherently accurate. When shooting with a gouger cannon, there is an additional -1 accuracy, which we did not know.
Okay.
So, that's weird. So it's 5, then 4, then 3, then 2. I should be hitting a lot less. So, actually, oh no, I'm not doing rapid fire, so I still do 3s. Okay.
Derek, you would never understand.
So that's a big deal,
Derek,
actually. I mean, some of those guys might have actually lived from the last round.
That's all right.
But we've already backtracked so many times.
Yeah, no, we're not going to do it again.
Yeah. Obstacles, more scrub, 10, that's not going to be 4 cooldowns, 10 to shoot. Does this thing have an index?
Yeah, it does. I think in the back.
Those things are heavy.
Can you do me a favor? Can you take a look at the reference sheet and see if it says anything about blast?
What?
The quick reference sheet to see if it says anything about blast winner.
Alright, well, no.
Who knows?
Move his agility. Break test triggers. Fail. Resist. Assault. Reactions. Agility. Orders. Nothing about glass.
I may actually just not do it because we can't find the stuff for it. Blind fire, overhead, cover, occupied terrain, hits on buddy drones. Yeah, I'm not finding it. So how about this? I'm just going to shoot you normally.
Okay.
I mean, I guess if I can't find it, I might as well just not mess with it, I guess. Which is really a shame because I was really careful. I mean, the thing is, it sounds to me like it seems to me, tertiarily, that it seems like it would be a case of, especially considering the strength of the hit is so low to start. It's a case of I have to roll to hit, and then if I do, I add a d4 to it, and that's the actual weapon strength.
Okay.
That sounds like how that would work, but I don't know for certain. I can't find the damn rule. Limited ammo. Wait. May have found something here. Special rules for units. Dang it! Man, they really do not make it easy to find some units in this game. Or in this book.
Yeah, I know
you are. That's what I'm saying. If we had an army builder with all those stuff, little stats on the thing.
Alright, so we'll do the regular shot. The regular shot is a strength 4, I think. And whatnot. So, negative 1 for movement, negative 1 for the inherent accuracy problem, and negative 1 for range, so I go from 5 down to the new 2s. I'm not hitting squat out. That point, I might as well almost just go down and just, I only need 1s and just make it rapid fire. Alright, so 3 guys, I need 3, I need, sorry, we need 2s. Or 2s or 1s. I got nothing. 5, negative 1, 4, movement.
Okay.
Yeah, so 5 by 3 is 2. Yeah, so I totally missed. Alright, so they're out in the open, totally missed.
Alright,
let's take another one from the bag.
And the bag.
Oh, wait, is this supposed to be in there?
No.
Okay. And it is one of yours.
Ta-da!
We're back to being nice to each other.
Okay, these guys here, they're going to advance. So they're going to move 5.
I want to watch me square.
Let's see here.
It's not strange.
No, it's a new square. Yeah, that plasma carbine.
It's not square.
No, it's here.
Plasma carbine.
I mean,
plasma lance, plasma. Okay, shooting modes. Unit with one carbine can use one of 2 modes: longer range, harder hitting single gun, or the shorter range rapid fire scatter. All models in the unit must use the same mode. Or 2 rapid fire. So.
What about USA?
Yeah. Sorry, I'm just trying to find all the.
No, please. Okay, that's the. So strike value is 2. It's a single shot, so that's 1. So that would bring your defense down to -2. Right. So we do 5 shots.
5 shots, and whatever I hit, I got to roll against the feet.
Right.
Does it make it any easier if my guys are completely out in the open, or you just don't take a penalty for them at the cover?
Well, they're not in any cover, right?
Okay, so it's just a case of I don't get a bonus for cover, but it doesn't make it easier for me to hit. Okay. See, that was the other thing with heavy gear, was in the original rules, they're like, oh, are you in the open? It gets even easier. I'm like, this is stupid. So you got 1, you got 2 hits.
2 hits?
Yeah, the 1 and the 3.
Okay.
So I'm rolling against that. And you're looking, I got to roll 8 or less. Because the resistance is 10 to start. Sure, this is all the right number.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, yeah.
1 pin.
Oh,
I made both.
Wow.
Do I have to roll less or is it that?
Equal or less?
Equal or less. Okay. So my guys are alive.
Yay!
Okay. So, dice all over the place. All right, hand it back.
Yep.
Hand it back.
Your die or mine? Sounds like a horrible pickup line. Hey, baby, your die or mine?
Oh, sure.
My guys are going to fire. They're going to stay exactly where they're going to stay where they are. They're going to fire. And I'm going to take shots from here to that. It's going to be probably close to 30 inches. It's definitely not 20. So I'm not going to. Oh, actually, no, you guys moved up, so the range actually needs to change.
Yes.
So.
Yeah,
it's 20 inches at least. So, it's just out of range. So, negative one, so I'm down to two, down to three or less. And.
3 miles square radius.
Three. Now I'm better off doing the heavy single shot. And I got one that hit.
Okay.
So it's strength 4. So your guys are only gonna live to roll 1.
Whoa!
Holy snikes!
Wow!
No! Okay.
Just check my number.
Watch Tiger Bunny. My kids.
There was this one guy who painted the dials like perfectly, and I said, "Well, that's all nice and well, but." When you move them, all the paint starts to go off.
Yeah. I can see that being a problem.
Yeah.
Alright. So let's pull one out of the bag. See, now the game's more interesting, now that we know that my guys are not supposed to be as accurate as they were. And it's one of yours.
Okay.
Oh, dang it, sorry.
Alright, no problem. Alright, so they're going to... These guys are going to try to move and shoot. So we're going to do 5.
So they're advancing.
They're advancing, yes.
Mm-hmm.
And they're gonna try to shoot. Now we're gonna really, this kind of. He's got ya. He's got ya. Right?
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much.
Okay. Yeah, you can all shoot that one. The one guy in the lead.
Now, being that they are pinned, I'm sure it's a little harder for me to hit you. So, what do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4 range.
Oh, I should have taken into account the fact my guy had a pin marker.
So, we're all going to figure this out. I'm finding that I'm really liking this game and that I want to definitely keep with it.
Yeah.
And then,
I'm back.
Let's see. Okay, so we're pinned. So I'm saying that that's going to be like a minus one for just being pinned. Plus okay. you're in cover, so that's minus 2.
Yeah.
All right.
And
so
the range is less. Oh no, actually, you're probably within 20. You've got to be. I'd be surprised if you're not. I can handle it from the other end. So go to here. That's you're what, yeah. 18 inches.
Yeah.
You're fine. So, negative 2, so whatever your accuracy is.
And that was 5.
Oh, it's 5, so you do 3s.
Eric.
And I see 1.
Nice.
Okay.
And strike 2?
Yeah. So, well, that'd be 2 hits, right? Because if it's a 5, it's either equal or under.
Yeah, but aren't you taking a negative
1? Oh, yeah.
1 negative 1 for movement and negative 1
hit. Two. That's right.
Okay. No, I just want to make sure my math was wrong, actually. And I'm okay!
You're good.
I'm really okay.
Yeah.
Pin goes away too. Don't you know?
Well, there's a way that, I think there's a way you make a pin go away, but I can't
remember.
Well,
aside from rallying, I guess.
Yeah, I guess that's how you know.
All right, so let's pull one out of the bag.
Yeah.
I think I pulled it last time as well. It's me this time. Oh.
Good old Fartok.
Imagine me cruising on Route 9 with this thing.
He's gonna advance, and so he's gonna. I need the tape runner. He's gonna move, and he's gonna shoot. Give you. That's 5, and he can kind of see one of the dudes over there. So I mean, it's gonna be like -1 for cover, and actually, what is he even armed with? You've got the book.
So here's the question. If I can... It's 20 inches. I've got 20 inches, so... As long as I can shoot that far, I guess I get a shot with something.
He's armed with a pistol-y thing.
Yeah, so 20 inches might be pushing it.
Far top. Well, he's not in his battle armor.
Mm-hmm.
You might want to look at
okay.
What he is.
Okay. It's here. Infantry command. It does not say. I guess he doesn't do anything.
Yeah, he has a pistol.
We'll see if there's a pistol stat in the GAR.
Yeah, in the GAR weaponry.
Yeah.
Well, weaponry.
Oh, I think that's a gouger gun. I think that's probably supposed to be. Nope, that's still supposed to be a skeleton cannon. Okay, the only thing that remotely looks like it could be anything that he would have is the gouger gun.
Okay.
Which again gives me down and inaccurate. So, effective range of 10 to 20. So, I guess that's what it's supposed to be.
Oh, the upstairs?
Yeah. All right, so I guess 10 to 20, so he's in optimal range.
All right.
So I guess I get one shot. And my guys, and...
You know it's actually ice cream,
of course. Now I lose the freaking pictures.
It's actually ice cream. If you look at it, it's ice cream. That's right. Yeah, you're right. Alright, so like, I thought that poop would go up and then... The way you freaked out that day when we changed the color, when I changed the color, Joe was freaking out.
I was like, what the hell? I'm like, why is the color different? I'm sitting there like, what?
You should have seen Joe. You should have seen Joe. Like Joe was
like, "See what I was?" Wait, what?
Joe was like, "How did you do that?"
And she's like, "Give me the phone." She's like, "My phone." She's like, "This ain't changing."
I guess
you
got quite accurate.
I love
Brian. I kind of lost it again.
That is sexy. I'm
trying to find this
one
thing.
I actually got changed it to pink on everyone. They're like,
"Just
no,
not doing
no.
so good here." We'll say 5 accuracy, and awesome to have it. So 5, and then -1 for cover. So he's down to, and it's inaccurate because it's got that inaccuracy thing on ballistic. So I'm still great. It's an 8. I missed. All that to find out that I missed.
All right.
So moving on to taking another die out. So that's you. It's gonna be one of your guys at least.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Actually, do you know where your guys go? These guys. I don't think you put the die in back from last round.
I didn't?
I don't remember, because didn't these guys move last round? Instead of this round?
Yeah, they didn't move, yeah.
So, yeah, you're missing a die.
What the heck?
So, what's in there?
I don't know what it is. Did we get 979?
A whole bunch of three dice. With the air grade there.
What's going on, man? Okay.
We're gonna fix this right now.
Alright.
This is a squad.
This is a squad.
That's a squad. These dice are
gone
in the bag.
Those
you have a squad.
Squad, so we're good.
And then this dice should be in the bag.
Yeah.
Alright.
All right, so now these guys are going to do something.
And then they're going to do something, and they're going to...
I didn't want an angle. Wow. Like, I love this hand, but where's the force?
They're going to... advance. They'll try to advance. So they're moved halfway in.
I don't think they can shoot.
Oh, is it too much terrain?
Well, here, give me the rules. If we do... They got you. How many inches is that? That's 23 inches. So
now what is it? It looks like 20.
20. Yeah.
Yeah. So you got your optimal band.
All right. So could they do off a shot?
I'd say yes. Okay. If they advance, then yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So they got you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then the commander 6.
I have what I got.
Are you going to do the single shots for?
Yeah, single shot.
I thought you were going to go rapid.
No. Like, Joe, you guys very rare, really good. Okay. And, I'm sure that your group
My
Aunt
Brady has
So, you're looking for. I guess you'd be looking for. Threes again?
Threes?
Well, negative one for movement. You have 5 accuracy, right?
Right.
Negative one for moving, yes. And then negative one for my guy's terrain.
Right.
So you're looking for threes.
Threes will last.
So you got two, three. You have to admit.
Right.
All right. I need 8s or better in order to survive. Or 8s or less. Everybody survived.
Okay.
Because my guys have a resistance of 10. Dang it. And I'm moving the terrain around.
Okay, now the only thing you do is you add a pin to you.
Add a pin, you're right. You are correct, sir, and when you're right, you're right.
Because that's the only one that can kill you, is if I keep shooting at you.
I think that's actually my bigger threat, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so...
Okay, I moved.
Yeah, so let's put all the dice back in the bag.
Now we're... We got it. Like unlimited dice here.
Yeah, I was like, wow, this seems really kind of you heavy. Oh, it's me this time. Taking it for myself. Now I have a question. If I do advance, can I fire then move?
I don't think so.
It has to move in front.
Yeah, I think you have to move in front. Yeah.
That kind of sucks. All right.
I mean, I haven't seen anybody do that, so I don't know.
All right, you know I'm gonna all advance these guys. All right, so we're gonna have them advance. They're gonna move 5 inches.
Yeah.
So that's 5 inches. 5 inches. All right, and they'll take their shot. I'm gonna do that rapid fire thing. That gives me 3 shots per guy. So I have negative one, but I've got to move 20 inches at this point.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm good. So 20 inches, or, you know, whatever. shut up! Yeah, so we got the 20 inches, and... I think when I do the rapid fire mode, it's negative 2, I think is what it was. Or, I think it's a 2 strength. Scour can. Rapid fire 3, strength 2. So I need to get 3s.
Yeah.
Is what I'm looking for. So I need
9
dice. 3.
That's your.
So there's 9. I'm looking for 3s. Threes or less. 1. Really, that's it? I got 1.
Wow.
You were complaining about your rolling. I don't want to hear it. You're done. You're off complaining for the rest of the game.
Okay, I can't complain no more.
All right, roll 1 die, and you're looking for you have a resistance of 5, so you're looking for 3 or less.
All right, plus I have a pin.
Oh, so you're looking for 2 or less.
Wow.
Who's the guy?
Who's the guy? Gain a pin. Gain a pin. Gain a pin.
Oh, yeah.
Or just move the counter up. One.
Oh.
Or that. Okay, so that's my guy, so you gotta take one out of the back. I was really hoping that was gonna go a lot better than that.
Oh, me?
Oh, yeah.
Alright, okay. Oh, I got shot at.
And they're down. Those guys are
yeah,
down.
Oh,
yeah.
So I can't use these guys, bastard.
They're down, so you gotta put one out of the bag.
Right.
Because that would have just been put on them.
I'll do it easy. No, I gotta do it. Alright. Down.
Looking for the down. Somewhere
wow,
out there, there's only six sides.
I know.
There's only so many sides you can find.
There we go.
And then you drop it. It's on my setup. Alright. Here you go. They're down.
No, I am.
Okay, so you pulled one. So that's going to be for one of your
this guy over here. They're going to advance. Once I find the advance. I got the advance. Okay.
You got a 1 in 6 chance of finding it.
So they're going
to
move.
He's like, well, since it's snowing, go back to South Carolina. And she's like, okay, here's
clean
letter.
This is just being silly, but I don't care.
Advance. No guts in their glory, right?
Advance.
He who dares wins.
That's right. Well, a friend of mine says he's freaking people out because in real warfare, they never go run to the side, run behind something. You know, they always go, come on, men, go forward.
Yeah.
So that's kind of stupid.
And if you're in Russia, it's go forward. Did you just take a step backwards? Yeah, that's not going to work.
You're going to get shot. You're going to die. Commissar is going to kill you.
But then you get plus one to your morale. Okay, so who are we shooting at?
Who are we going to shoot at? We're going to try
these guys are right
closer.
Out of the
store.
Yeah.
So we're going to try them. And let's see, what is that, a 9?
Let's see here, they're out in the open. You're in optimal range, but you moved, so you're looking for fours.
Fours, and I got a 1.
So I got 1 of them. And I need 8 or less in order to survive. And I lose a guy. Yeah. Unless he's got structure. I don't think so, though. I think it's a case if he just dies.
Throw the pin on him.
I didn't see anything in there that said anything about I get to, like, live through it. Because I got armor or anything like that. I think it's just in case my guy's just a little bit tougher to kill.
No, I don't see anything in there.
Before you end your turn?
So plasma reactor. You know what? I'm not even going to worry about it. I don't even know what it is.
We haven't used it yet. I'm not worrying about it now.
All right. So basically what that move does is it just makes them lose a turn. Basically.
Yeah, it makes it so you can't use one of your guys.
Yeah.
These guys will shoot at those guys.
All right.
You get... I haven't pulled a die, so maybe I don't. Duh, I'm so used to like, oh, you go, I go.
Yeah.
I'm so used to that whole mechanic. And I'm sitting here going, darn.
No, this is a little different. I thought you pulled a die, so
no, I didn't. I didn't. No, I did.
Right.
They will fire. And they're going to fire to here, which is automatically going to down them, which is going to end your turn.
That's okay.
-1 accuracy, -1 for cover. I'm gonna have range. I mean, it's 20 inches.
Yeah.
It's 20 inches because it's 20 inches.